Hello, I'm Jürgen Behlmann from Sophistic. In this video, I want to show you some more aspects on the CSM optimization. If you start analyzing a bridge, you should always start on the final system, that means without construction stages. Here, in this example, we should reach 8 targets on traffic opening that are here 7 displacements VZ and 1 displacement VX that shall be 0 at traffic opening. So we need 8 scalable load cases, and of course that are the stressing load cases of the cables 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for the backstays. The main idea is when we reach 0 deflection at traffic opening here, we automatically get a straight bridge and we get a balanced bending moment in our superstructure. So this is our real target. A second example would be this bridge, including construction stages. In this YouTube video, I will show you how to make an optimization with nonlinear cable sagging. By the way, the names of the example files are CSM21 and CSM23. And there is also a good YouTube video showing the linear optimization on these two examples with the name CSM Force Optimization. To show a nonlinear optimization, I now use another system that is called CSM20, and we can use it for the final system and including construction stages. First, optimization on the final system. Again, we have our 4 targets, 1, 2, 3, 4. Of course, the same on the other side, but our system is symmetrically, so we can concentrate on this 4 targets. Of course, the scalable load cases that we can use are stressing cable 1, 2, 3 and the backstays. We now want to calculate our scalable load cases. We calculate all scalable load cases on the final system, but we now want to take into account the cable sagging. So we use a frozen stiffness of a primary load case where we include cable sagging. This can be analyzed quite easy. We make sysprop TH3, including cable sagging. We activate all groups and estimate a pre-stress, activate dead load and the additional dead load. We start maybe with a pre-stress of 1000, deactivate all procs, activate only this module and run the system. When we look to the animator, we get a big sagging. So we see 1000 was not enough. Maybe we take 3000 and run it again. The deflection gets less. We make 7000. The deflection is negative, so we end up in 5500. And now the deflection is quite good, and we have a cable sagging included, giving us a nonlinear stiffness for the cable sagging that is used in the next step, frozen stiffness. Now comes the normal equation run CSM. We have 1, 2, 3 targets and scalable load cases with UZ and 1 with UX for the pylon. We run this CSM that creates the factors for the optimization. In the next ASE, these factors are used as scalable load cases and we calculate our load case 92. In this load case 92, the deformations are quite good, but not 100% correct because it is a nonlinear system. Therefore, we rerun this equation system a second time, getting new corrected factors that we use here with load case fact eater, and run the system for the next time. Now the displacements in load case 93 are perfect. And as the displacements are perfect and we are calculating on the final system, also our bending moments are perfect balanced. So we have finished our optimization, including cable sagging. Quick to repeat, we make a first estimate run. We calculate the scalable load cases with the frozen stiffness. Then we make our optimization equation run to reach the targets, getting new factors for the scalable load case. And we take these factors in the next ASE step. We have to make two or three steps as it is a nonlinear system. Now let's go to a system with construction stages. As I told before, we now cannot use displacements. We must use bending moments as target. But hello, Jürgen, please stop. Why can we not use the same displacement targets as here? It went so well and was so easy. Okay. Let's check and let's see what happens if we use displacements as targets. We plan our construction sequence. We start with the towers, insert the first segment, stress the first cable, next segment, stress the cable, next segment, stress the cable, backstays, stress the backstays. You see, we have a nonlinear cable sagging. Then we activate the weight of the last segment and then the last segment itself, and finally the additional dead load. We see the displacements are not perfect and we can now optimize these displacements. So we make our first CSM run with the stages. Then we make a plot of the results with WinGraph. Now our optimization run, again using three scalable load cases with the U set deformation target and one for the UX for the pylon. And we run the analysis again. We make EQET1 to make only one iteration, because now, after the first iteration, we can make a WinGraph plot to check the results. Then we can just run the second optimization, check the results after the second optimization, and then a third run. This is the result after the first CSM run. In the next step, you see the displacements are better. This was the first one, now the second run. The displacements are here now quite good. The next run and the last run, we see our target displacement zero is reached. Here and here and here and here, we reached our target. But we see here a problem, and the bending moment is not balanced. Let's look at the optimized CSM result. The tower, the first segment, stressing, and now we add the next element with control cantilever 2, of course, tangential prestress, and therefore this node comes too high. Now we continue with our analysis, and when we insert the last segment, we see that we insert a kink, and this kink gives the problem of the not balanced bending moment in the center, and of course the support that is too high here gives the problem of the non-balanced bending moment in the side span. So the deformation targets are reached, but we do not get what we want. Okay, now I understand. So let's take force targets, that means bending moments, and in case the displacements are not well, we can just pre-camber it. So this is the reason why we have to use bending moments. With the first stressing of the cable, we can best check the bending moment at this point. The second cable, of course, the bending moment on the left side. With the third cable, we can best scale the bending moment at this position. And with the backstays, we can best get a bending moment zero in the pylon. But now we need two more targets to get a good bending moment at this position and a good bending moment at this position. When we insert the last segment, all four cables are already stressed. So how can we manipulate the bending moment at this position? One possibility is to insert a ballast force before the closing of the segment, and then when it is connected, we remove the ballast. And with this removing of the ballast, we can change the bending moment at this position. Of course, the same we do on the side span with a ballast at this position. In the input, we insert a construction stage ballast midspan and a stage remove ballast. The same for the side span. Then in the optimization run, we can use these load cases of the ballast to optimize the bending moment at these two positions, at the beginning of the last segment in midspan and the last segment in sidespan. We again start with only one iteration so that we can make a wind graph plot after the first iteration, make the next optimization run, and then another check of the second iteration. Checking these plots, we see the bending moment of the first estimated pre-stress, then after the first iteration, second, third iteration, and now we see nearly we reached 8,000 kilonewton meter at every point. Checking the analysis in the animator, we see first segment erected, stressed, next segment, stressed, next segment, stressed. And now comes ballast on side span, the weight of the last segment, the last segment hardened, cable inserted, cable stressed, and remove of ballast at this side. The same now in midspan. We insert the ballast at this point, we insert the weight of the last segment, we activate the last segment, we fix the hinges, and we remove the ballast. And in the very last step, we add the additional dead load. This gives a well-balanced bending moment in the superstructure. But we see the deformations are not 100% okay, but this is not a problem. We can just pre-camber this deformation. This pre-camber we can achieve by activating this line camber so that the program tries to get zero deformation in construction stage 500. If you look to the example file CSM20 staged analysis, you can also see how you can produce a plot of the necessary pre-camber for this analysis. To conclude, with these targets of bending moments, we have now reached, after three iterations, a balanced bending moment, including nonlinear cable sagging, and in parallel, we have included a pre-camber. One important hint, if you make an optimization like this, please always start with a linear analysis, because it may be that your linear result gives a compression in a cable. And then, of course, it is not possible to get an optimization result in the non-linear analysis. So, thanks for listening and goodbye!